Hello friends, in this session we will talk about the change of roots in quadratic equations. Let us say I'm given an equation x square plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. If I'm given this equation, which is x plus 1 whole square, if I'm given this equation and we are asked to find the equation whose roots are greater by 2. So if we are asked to find the equation whose roots are greater by 2. So because here I know that the roots are 1 and 1, because this is minus 1, I'm sorry, minus 1 and minus 1, this will be the roots of this. This can be simply written as x plus 1 whole square. X plus 1 whole square equals to 0, so x equals to minus 1. So minus 1 and minus 1 are the roots of this equation. If I'm looking for the equation whose roots are greater by 2, that means that the roots would be minus 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1. And if the roots are plus 1 plus 1, then I can say that the equation will be x minus 1 whole square. So that will become x square minus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. Also, if in this equation I had substituted x minus 1, then x minus 2, then I would have got the same result. So if I have got x square plus 2x plus 1 equal to 0, if instead of x I substitute this with x minus 2, let's see what happens, and then I will generalize this. If I make it x minus 2, this will become x minus 2 whole square plus 2 into x minus 2 plus 1 is equal to 0. This becomes x square minus 4x plus 2x is minus 2x, plus 4 minus 4 cancels out, and plus 1 is equal to 0, which you will observe is the same as this. Is there a coincidence? No, it is not. There is a method here. What we can do is, if I'm looking for roots that are greater by 2, I could do a x minus 2. That will give me the same thing. If I'm looking for roots that are minus 3, I could do a x plus 3. So whatever I'm looking for, do the opposite of that with x and you will get your result. Why? How? Understand this. If the roots initially are x minus alpha into x minus beta is equal to 0. Now, if I want to do a alpha plus k, comma beta plus k. So, for this equation, for with alpha plus k and alpha beta plus k, I will have x minus alpha plus k into x minus beta plus k is equal to 0, which can be written as x minus k minus alpha, x minus k minus beta is equal to 0. Which is nothing but x has been replaced with x minus k, and alpha and beta, they remain the way they are. So therefore, merely restating, I get if you want the roots to become x alpha plus k beta plus k, x minus k will do the job. If I had wanted the subtraction here, this would have been addition, and so on and so forth. So cut the clutter, come straight to the point. And the point is very, very simple. If I'm given an equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 with roots alpha comma beta, if I'm looking for alpha plus k, I should replace x with x minus k. X with x minus k. If I'm looking for alpha minus k, then this should become x plus k. If I'm looking for alpha into k, then it should become x divided by k. If I'm looking for alpha divided by k, then it should be x multiplied by k. If I'm looking for 1 upon alpha, this would be interesting. If I'm looking for 1 upon alpha, well, this will be of the form cx square plus bx plus a is equal to 0. Alternately, I have done a 1 upon x. So this has been arrived at using a 1 upon x. How do I do a 1 upon x? The equation was ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. If I replace x with 1 upon x, I will get a upon x square plus b upon x plus c is equal to 0. Now, if I multiply throughout by x square, I will get cx square plus bx plus a. Cx square plus bx plus a is equal to 0. So, for the roots to become reciprocals, you have to do a 1 upon x. So, that will be the basic idea on arithmetic operations on the roots. Another variety of questions that we would like to discuss here while we are at the change of roots. Let us say I am given an equation x square plus 4x plus 3 is equal to 0. Has two roots alpha comma beta. We have to find the equation with roots 1 plus alpha upon beta and 1 plus beta upon alpha. So, if I am giving the equation x square plus 4x plus 3 equals to 0 has two roots alpha comma beta, then find the equation with roots 1 plus alpha upon beta and 1 plus beta upon alpha. Obviously, we can calculate the roots of this equation, we will know the value of alpha beta. If we know that, we will know the value of 1 plus alpha plus beta, 1 plus beta upon alpha, and we can form the quadratic equation using that. But then let's not take that approach here. Here what we will do is we'll use this change, well, we'll keep it in the form of alpha and beta only, so that when we are faced with more complicated questions, we are able to understand this concept better. From here, what I understand is alpha plus beta is equal to minus 4 and alpha beta is equal to 3. As we had discussed earlier, alpha plus beta is minus b by a and alpha beta is equal to c by a. So, this is known to me. Now, from here, in order to form the equation, what I require is the sum of these two numbers and the product of these two numbers, of these two variables. If I am looking at the sum, 1 plus alpha upon beta plus 1 plus beta upon alpha is equal to 2 plus alpha upon beta plus beta upon alpha, which will be equal to 2 plus, this becomes alpha square plus beta square upon alpha beta. Now, alpha square plus beta square is equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta divided by alpha beta. Now, as far as this is concerned, this can be written as 2 alpha beta if I do it like this. Now, 2 alpha beta minus 2 alpha beta will cancel. So, this is equal to alpha plus beta whole square upon alpha beta. So, from here we get the sum of the roots. The second part is the product of the roots. If we are looking at the product of the roots, for product, the product is 1 plus alpha upon beta multiplied by 1 plus beta upon alpha. This is equal to 1 plus alpha upon beta plus beta upon alpha plus this will become alpha upon beta into beta upon alpha, that is equal to 1. So, this is equal to 2 plus alpha upon beta. So, that will also be the same. So, incidentally, the sum and the product both are same. So, that is also equal to overall this will become alpha plus beta whole square upon alpha beta. Now, from here, I know that alpha plus beta is equal to minus 4. So, minus 4 square is 16. Alpha beta is equal to 3. So, this is equal to 16 upon 3. And if this is equal to 16 upon 3, the equation is x square minus sum of the roots into k into x plus the product of the roots. So, the general form of the equation will become x square minus sum of the roots 16 upon 3. So, minus 16 upon 3 into x plus the product of the roots 16 upon 3 is equal to 0. This is your answer. In general, what you need to keep in mind from here is that whenever we are asked to perform this kind of operations on this, we need to be able to convert this variable into alpha plus beta and alpha beta. Because if we know this from here, we will know the value of alpha plus beta and alpha beta. So if we are able to convert whatever is given here in the form of alpha plus beta and alpha beta, automatically there we can substitute the value and we would be done. So a little bit of understanding of basic algebraic operations, that will be important in this. So if we have a reasonable hand on the algebraic operations, we would be able to sort this out. We will discuss the basic algebraic operations elsewhere. So I think for now this should be good enough.